guess what time it is? It's time to check your local IQ.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby. All right. I like it. Local IQ time. It's Monday. Even if it's the holiday, he's here.
I'm back.
The curious townie is everywhere.
I am everywhere.
Glad to have you back.
I'm happy to be back.
You were on quite some adventures.
I've been on several adventures, and I heard that Siobhan filled my hat very well.
Literally.
Last week, literally. I brought a big hat to show her up this time. it's got some other symbolism to it today. Anyway, I'm just going to speak real briefly. Our new issue is on the stand. De La Rosa, it's a good issue about happy hour that Justin put together a really good team, and it's a wonderful, wonderful feature.
Especially for this time of year, I like all the outdoor dining and patios.
With some really cool photos from Wes Naaman.
And some secret bars.
Yeah.
Like
and then on page 27, and I'm sure we'll be showing it on the big screen later.
Yes.
We're finally promoting our team of five from the IQ.
Look at that.
Yeah.
It's such a cool picture
of
you guys.
Look at that.
I know. We're so excited.
Check it out. Look at that photo.
There
we
go. Can you
see
it? Yeah. So we'll be.
That's our IQ
team. We'll probably be using it as one of the icons when we're talking and stuff. So, it's fun. Wes Naaman's a great photographer. You met him here on the show.
He really is.
Yeah.
So it was a fun photo shoot with him. And, you know, there's a party of five of us that are having a really good time with you guys.
Awesome.
Well, we love having you guys.
I love being here. So, I did just get back. I spoke about the Altovar, but I just got back from a week up at the Mabel Dodge Lujan House in Taos, and then a really incredible bed and breakfast that I came across because of Susan Seligman called Casa de Gavilan in Cimarron, and it blew my mind away.
Really? That's good.
So it's amazing. So that's my teaser. June 6th, Destinations feature comes out. I spent the entire weekend writing. I've got some more writing to do, but it's gonna be a really cool issue, and I'm happy to be home, but resonating on the good stuff. So,
welcome back.
Thank you.
Glad to have you back. Good to see you back.
Anyway, so want to save some time because we've got Aaron from Tricklock, which is one of my favorite theater companies in this town, and they're doing some really cool stuff right now.
We are.
So I'm gonna hand it over to Aaron.
Okay.
Here we go.
Cool.
Nice
Thank you for
have
being
you.
Here.
Thanks for having me. I'm really glad to be here. Yeah, we've got some really great stuff happening. You know, we just closed actually our 19th season of professional theater here in Albuquerque,
That's
which
awesome.
Is really incredible and crazy. And in August, we're going to be kicking off our 20th season, which will be a really, really incredible season full of actually some shows that we have done in our earlier years of the company's work.
Oh, wow.
And we're bringing all of them back. So it's sort of like a revival season, and it's going to be really, I'm really excited because some of these shows are actually from before my time in the company.
Oh, okay.
I've been with the company since 2006. And so some of these shows are from the early years. So we'll get to all be a part of it. And in the meantime, we've got a really exciting summer coming up. Tricklock has a lot of education programs that we do that primarily happen in the summer. So we have our annual Manoa Project, which is our teen ensemble building and ensemble work creation program. So it's a really intensive training program that we partner with the National Hispanic Cultural Center on. So we start that in a week and train some high schoolers in the methods that Tricklock uses, which is a lot of like original work creation, original playwriting, and then a lot of physical theater techniques to tell these stories. And then we also have a really exciting partnership that is happening now with Harwood Arts Center and Escuela del Sol. And they run a really fabulous arts camp. And last summer, we came in as instructors on some of those classes. And this summer, we decided that we'd like to start making this partnership a little bit stronger even. And so we're a little more present in their program kind of as co-sponsors of this program. And the goal is that we'll actually get some training and some opportunities for these younger students throughout the year through different community centers. And so that partnership with Harwood is really exciting for us.
Seems like a perfect marriage with you guys in Harwood.
It is, and there, you know, our education programs to this point have been really at the high school level or late middle school level, and then we're the theater in residence at UNM, so we get a lot of opportunity to work with the college students, but the young kids, we haven't really found our groove with them yet, so we're really excited to partner with Harwood and hopefully kind of reach all age levels to spread some arts education around in the city. So that's really exciting. Yeah.
And that's what makes you guys so great. You're not just a theater company. You also, you teach. You have all these workshops, which make you so different.
Well, we really, really value being the theater in residence at UNM. That was part of our transition. A lot of people who know us from our old space on Washington and Central, mm-hmm. part of the transition there, leaving that space, was becoming the theater in residence. And then for the past year, we've been in our new home downtown at 2nd and Gold at the Tricklock Performance Laboratory, right across from the Box Performance Space, another fabulous venue in town. And to have our performance home again, we're still in residence at UNM, mm-hmm. but we're, you know, in the process of really making our space our home, our permanent home now.
I love that name. We should call the studio a performance laboratory.
Yeah, it's like automatically a little like saucy, right?
It's
like
a laboratory.
Yeah, we've got some strange creatures running around.
Exactly. It buys you some experimentation. You're like, no, it's a lab. Yeah, it's great. It's great.
We have a photo of the company here.
This is our brand new company photo, actually.
Look at the portrait here. Look at all that.
Oh, look at these pretty people who I love so much. This photo, I have to give a little plug also, is by the fabulous photographer Shastin Friedman. Give her a little shout out.
I love her.
Shastin is amazing. Shastin's on our board of directors along with a bunch of other fabulous folks from around town. And she took this new photo for us so we could have an updated shot for our 20th season. So.
And that looks like it's downtown, right?
It was.
It's a little park right by
exactly,
where you're located.
Exactly. That really interesting little tiny sliver of a park right at 2nd and Gold. And that installation, I think, went down like 2 days after we took that picture. So we were like,
oh wow.
Capture that. Use that for a while.
You know, Tricklock is the gift that keeps on giving, too, because a lot of people in the community don't know, but you do a lot of exchanges with other theater companies.
We do. Touring and international exchange is actually a huge priority of ours. It's part of our mission. We produce annually the Revolutions International Theater Festival, and completely non-biasedly, I have to say it's one of the most incredible things that I think happens in this city. I know I'm partial.
Yes,
but
you are.
We spend every year, that happens in January annually, and we spend the rest of the calendar year searching the globe for companies to bring here who might not otherwise ever be in Albuquerque. And, you know, last year we had our 13th festival this past January, and we had a company from Denmark who had never even been to the United States before. And their first time was in Albuquerque.
Oh, wow.
So it's really special for us. And then we, of course, have the priority of touring around the world, and that's sort of where those exchanges happen.
Wonderful.
So, yeah.
So what are some events that are coming up, some shows?
So we have a really exciting collaboration, actually, from a company who had been in Revolutions 2 years ago. Their name is Baron Theater Company. They're a really interesting sort of satellite. Like, they're primarily based in Brooklyn right now, but they have roots in Kansas. They have members who live in LA. Here's some shots of my good friends from Baron Theater Company in their show Nightmares, which they've had in development and in multiple sort of iterations for, oh gosh, like 6 years maybe.
Wow.
And they just keep kind of coming back to it. It's, you know, similar to some of what Tricklock will do, where we're, you know, we have a show and it's in our backlog, but we want to keep working on it and keep exploring it. So they they're on a tour right now, and in each city that they go to, they're kind of recasting some of the actors for this production of Nightmares and kind of re-collaborating and revitalizing the piece and then performing it in each city. So I think they're in Lawrence, Kansas right now, which is sort of the root of their company members, and then they're coming here in just a few days, and then a few of us, some guest artists from Tricklock and some guest artists from around town, are going to work with them and kind of in a crash course. Like, they're crazy. They're like wacky and crazy, and I love them.
Where do they stay when they're here?
With me.
Yeah.
No, I mean, we're housing. They're some of my best friends, actually. We're still working. We might actually be able to put them up in a really fabulous bed and breakfast downtown for half of their time here, just so they're a little closer to our downtown space. But then, you know, we're all a big family, so they'll probably sleep on our couch.
If you need a fabulous young ingenue or a tall, distinguished-looking gentleman,
I will keep that. I will absolutely keep that in mind.
Not that we're...
You never know when we're going to come a-calling. Like, hey, remember when you offered? I hope you were serious.